Hey guys, I want to start this video with a big thank you to all of you for your love and support, which has made me reach over 200 subscribers in just 5 weeks' time. Today, I'm sharing the most requested recipe for a gluten-free bread, which is not only soft, but also tastes just like normal gluten bread. Now, without any wait, let's start the recipe. We'll take a small bowl, put 1/4 cup of warm water, add 3 tablespoons sugar, and then add 1 tablespoon active dry yeast. Mix it for a couple of seconds to dissolve the yeast, and then keep the mixture in a warm place for proofing. In the meantime, let's mix the rest of the ingredients. Take a large bowl. Add 1/3 cup of white rice flour, 2/3 cup of sorghum jowar flour, 1/2 cup potato starch, 1/2 cup corn starch, 1 tablespoon xanthan gum, and 1.5 teaspoon salt. Give it a slight whisk. I'm using a stand mixer, but you can use a hand mix to mix these. The yeast is now ready. Pour it onto our flour mix and start whisking using hand or stand mixer. Then add 1/3 cup oil. I have used canola oil, but any light non-fragrant oil would be fine. And then 3 eggs. Whisk the mixture for about 3 minutes on a medium speed. You might need to scrape off the dough from the sides a couple of times for the dough to combine evenly without any lumps. Since the dough will be wet and sticky, so you would need to oil all sides of your bread pan. Even then, I prefer using the parchment paper, especially for the bottom part, as even after oiling, the bread might get stuck to the bottom and then it becomes difficult to pull it out without damaging the bread. However, this isn't the issue for the sides. They can be easily pulled away with the help of a knife. If you do not have parchment paper, you can use food wrapping paper or aluminium foil. If you're using aluminium foil, just use it on the bottom, not on the sides, as it might not let your bread cook properly, resulting in a dense bread. The dough is ready. I'm taking help of my son to hold the parchment paper down, as otherwise the sticky dough pulls the parchment paper from the sides along with it, and since the paper becomes damp, it starts tearing off when you try to realign it. Even out the surface with the help of a damp spatula or your fingers. Keep the pan for proofing in a warm place covered with a plastic wrap or plastic polythene for 30 minutes or till it rises to about 1/2 inch above the pan. Please do not use a wet towel, as the risen dough will then stick to it, resulting in an uneven bread surface. After exact 30 minutes, look at how well the dough has risen. Now keep it on the bottom rack of a preheated oven at 180 degrees for 25 to 27 minutes. The soft and delicious gluten-free bread is ready. Let it cool down completely before slicing it. You can keep this bread wrapped with a parchment or a food wrapping paper in the fridge for about 4 to 5 days. Avoid cling wrap, as due to moisture lock-in, the bread starts to become wet from the middle, making it taste like a raw dough. Please try this recipe and share your comments. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon to get notifications on my latest uploads. You can also follow me on Facebook and Instagram as DNuttyGrains. Keep trying and enjoying these recipes. Bye-bye.